As the election season comes upon us, trolls are prevalently rummaging on social media platforms. Their endeavors to infest our thoughts will not go unforeseen. The fate of our country lies beneath our fingertips, so there is need to unmask the world of political trolling.
Have you encountered a troll before? If yes, why did you assume it was a troll?
Yes, nag-post ko about BBM and DDS na fake news. Tapos na ay nag-post, ang iyang reply, walay logical reasoning. Tapos i-review na ko iyang profile, walay picture, unya, walay gamay kayo ang information. Tapos ang ilang mga reasoning usually sa mga troll, bobo ka, tanga, pangit. So pag mo-counter ka og post about sa about unsay tinuod, ang pirmi ilang i-reply is kato, bobo, tanga, pangit.
Unsa man imong reaction?
Wala lang. Kay kabalo ko nga gibayaran sila para mag-post ana. Ila ng panginabuhi. So ang maayo nga buhaton disregard nimo ilang post.
So ang trolls ang ga-encourage sa imo na para mag-fact check.
Yes. Akong gina-double check ang akong opinion para ipa sabot sa ilaha nga unsay tinuod nga story about anang fake news. Pero ang trolls, dili sila mo tuuan ang imong gipost ang ilaha tungod kay gibayaran sila, iano ka, iharas, intimidate, mao lang na ilang tuyo.
When you talk about trolls, they are highly influential in terms of giving false information, and especially those people who are not yet informed, di ba? Technically, some of these trolls are quite intelligent in a way na they would really provide fake news or false information in general. So, especially right now, di ba? Ang mga tao ngayon, everything they see, everything they hear, automatically they would believe it without even fact-checking it, di ba? So, this could give misleading information to the people, since trolls are going to take advantage of that lack of knowledge of people around us.
Why do you think that people or the masses are so indulged in propagating fake news or participating in chismis?
Which is a good question, di ba? Yung mga marites sa ating society. When you talk about the marites, these are the chismosa or the gossip mongers, di ba? So, why do people really thrive, or especially common people, they are into gossips, di ba? You could look at it in different perspectives din kasi. Syempre, iba lang yung dating. If ever someone who is popular, someone who is well-known, pero meron siyang chismis, meron siyang gossip or scandal, di ba parang people are very enticed to know about it even more. It's like, you would look at it in society in general, we are living in a judgmental society wherein your actions are being judged and observed by people every bit of it. So, kung may mali kang magagawa, di ba, people would really make stories about you. Because, again, it's all part of the main topic, which is trolling, di ba? When you are trolling, of course, one of the main point of it is you're going to make a story about the person, especially if you want to bring down the person. Kaya, chismis would eventually lead to trolling. Kumaga, magpakalat ka ng fake news.
Trolls are actually brokers. There's a need for politicians to bridge the gap between them and the voters. So they cannot do it personally, no. As much as possible, they want it personally, no. So that they have a greater touch of the voting electorate. Right now, because of the pandemic, it seems like the concentration of campaign goes from face to face to social media. So I think that's the reason why we have trolls like right now. the difficulty of a face-to-face campaign in these pandemic times. And at the same time, no, it has already been proven that it is also effective in other countries, like for example, in Russia and in the United States.
How do they operate?
They are actually organized, they are recruited, and they are assigned in several numbered gadgets. Okay. So, yun. No? And how they work is that they are actually paid not only by the day, but they are also paid based on interactions. So we can they can actually count the interactions. So what happens that the more that people would interact with them, the more that they are getting paid. That's how actually it works. So for a troll, no, they would really make it to a point that they make their post as catchy as possible, you know, to the point that it is already considered fake news, you know, and we know that fake news would usually attack your emotions, you know, right? If you're getting attached to a particular issue, you know, despite the warnings of, you know, despite the warnings interacting with trolls, medyo, you know, you will be inclined to reply to trolls. However, usually the replies are uniform. So replies are already provided by their think tank. So meron na mga replies yon, and then, you know, they just post it. No? And every time that there would be a reply to their post, they would simply reply and continue with the conversation. Because what is being paid would be the exposure, you know, of their candidate, no? Or the exposure of the opposition, no? Of the opposing candidate. No? As much as possible, no, they want to destroy the character of the other candidate.
As thousands of trolls lurk online, with many of them who have mastered the arts of manipulation through fabricating fake identities, it can be very difficult to spot them.
First is that you can actually research on the account. Just click the account, and you can show you when the account was created, how many friends. Usually, if it's a very recent account and they don't have much friends, and that they actually also do not have many information about them, it's usually a troll. And you would observe that, you know, if you try to look at their post or their comments, usually they have similar sentences, you know, construction with other trolls, you know, that mostly belonging with the same group. So, but the best way to actually identify a troll is just to look at its account, you know, and if the account is just recent, and that it does not have much followers or friends, we can already conclude that it's a troll.
How can we avoid trolls?
How do you starve a troll? You starve a troll by not reacting, right? Not reacting to the post, not even commenting on the post, no? Because if there's no one addressing what the troll is posting, then the troll is not effective. And if the troll is not effective, then, you know, just like any other employee who's not effective, no, the troll gets fired. So that's what we usually do, no? You starve a troll. Or if you want it, the more legal side is that you report the account. So usually, you know, when you discover a troll, you just report the account and make the social media platform do its part in filtering trolls or fake news in their platform.
Due to the government's involvement in this issue, trolls remain predominant in our society. However, as individual citizens, we can take back the power trolls have over our political judgments by spotting them, discerning the veracity of their posts, and most importantly, by not feeding them.